Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the chapter Deep Water from class 12 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. Deep Water was written by William Douglas. William Douglas was born in Maine, Minnesota. He was an American jurist and politician who served as an associate justice for the Supreme Court of the United States. Nominated by President Franklin Roosevelt, Douglas was confirmed at the age of 40, one of the youngest justices appointed to the court. Before moving on, let us look at the theme and the sub-theme of the extract. This is a real-life personal account of experiencing fear and the steps taken to overcome it. And the sub-theme is the psychological analysis of fear. So before moving on, let us look at the meanings of these expressions. Treacherous. Treacherous means dangerous. Subdued my pride. Subdued my pride is to overcome the pride. Flailed at the surface. Flail at the surface is to swing your arms at the surface of the water. Fishing for landlocked salmon. Landlocked salmon is a species of fish. So fishing for that kind of a fish. Misadventure, some bad happening. Bob to the surface like a cork. Come back to the surface of the water immediately, as if when a cork is thrown, it just jumps up to the water. So come back to the, bounce back to the surface of the water. Curtain of life fell, that is the end of the life. Back and forth across the pool is to go both the lengths, go up and come down the length of the pool. So as I told you, this extract is a real life experience of the narrator about experiencing fear of water and what are the steps he took to overcome it. And he has also given a psychological dimension to his explanation. So let's move on to the chapter. It had happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. So he's talking about something and he says that it had happened when he was 10 or 11 years old. I had decided to learn to swim. So he wanted to learn to swim. There was a pool at the YMCA. So the YMCA, there was a swimming pool where he thought he would go and swim. In Yakima, that offered exactly the opportunity. So there was a swimming pool called YMCA in Yakima, and he wanted to go there to learn swimming. The Yakima River was treacherous, but there was also this river, Yakima River, which was treacherous, means dangerous. Mother continually warned against it. So his mother used to always warn him not to go to the Yakima River, and kept fresh in my mind the details of each drowning in the river. And every time she used to remind him about the number of drowning cases that happened at the Yakima River. And so she did not want him to go to the Yakima River. But the YMCA pool was safe. But he says that the YMCA pool that was there in Yakima was quite safe. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. And while it was 9 feet deep at the other, the drop was gradual. So he says that the YMCA swimming pool was quite safe because at one end of the pool it was only 3 feet deep and the other end was nine feet deep. And he says that the drop was also quite gradual. I got a pair of water wings and went to the pool. So we already saw that he wanted to learn to swim. So what he bought? He bought a pair of water wings to swim, and he took those water wings and went to the swimming pool. I hated to walk naked into it and show my skinny legs. So he was quite a shy kind of boy and he did not like to take off his clothes maybe. And so he says that I hated to walk naked into and show my skinny legs, especially because he had very thin, skinny means very thin, thin legs. So he did not want to show his thin legs. But I subdued my pride and did it. But then I overcame my pride because he did not want to show his legs. But somehow he overcame that pride and then he walked into the pool. However, I had an aversion to water when I was in it. So he says, from the beginning itself, I had an aversion to water when I was in it. So what is aversion? He had a strong dislike to water. He did not like to go into the water. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old and father took me to the California beach. So he is giving us the reason why he had this aversion to water. This happened when he was 3 or 4 years old. What happened? He and his father went to the California beach. He and I stood together in the surf. So he is explaining. He says that both he and his father went to a beach in California and both of them were standing on the beach and you know the waves were falling. Surf means here waves. The waves were coming and falling over their legs. I hung on to him, yet the waves knocked me down and swept over me. So what he says, I hung on to him, that means I caught hold of him tightly. But what happened? The strong waves came and knocked him down and swept over me. So the waves pushed him down and the water all came over him. I was buried in water. He says, I was covered with water. So when the waves fell on him, he fell down and the water covered him all over. My breath was gone and he says that he could not breathe properly at all because water was all over his body. I was frightened. Father laughed. So he's saying that I felt frightened because I fell down and the water is all over me and I'm not able to breathe. But what father did, he was just laughing. So was the father laughing seriously? No, but he was only thinking that the boy is playing with water and so he just smiled. But there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. So this boy became really frightened because of this incident, because he fell down, the waves knocked him down and he was not able to breathe. So this became very frightening. My introduction to the YMCA swimming pool revived unpleasant memories. So he says that when I started going to YMCA pool again, I started remembering these unpleasant incident of falling at the California beach. So he says that it was revived. Unpleasant memories means something that he did not like and stirred childish fears. So it all the fear again started coming up. That means he fell when he was 3 or 4 years, he fell down in the water and he was choked. And so this fear started coming up again when he came to the YMCA pool. But in a little while, I gathered confidence. But then he had a mind to learn swimming. So he says that I gathered confidence. I paddled with my new water wings, watching the other boys and trying to learn by aping them. So he says that he gained courage and he gained confidence. And then he started looking at other boys and tried to learn by aping them. What is aping them? By copying them or imitating them. So he was starting to, he would try to do what they did and in that way he wanted to learn swimming. I did this 2 or 3 times on different days and was just beginning to feel at ease in the water when the misadventure happened. So he says that though he was afraid of water, he gained confidence and he started going to the YMCA pool to learn swimming. And after going there, what he did? He used to look at the other boys and try to do what they did. And he also wanted to learn swimming. So this continued for 2 or 3 times by that is copying others and trying to do. But then he says it is at this time, but actually as he was trying to feel a little bit ease, he was trying to get off that fear from him, this misadventure happened. So this bad event happened when actually he was trying to overcome the fear of water. So what is the misadventure? He is giving us an explanation of what happened. I went to the pool when no one else was there. So one day what happened? He went to the swimming pool and nobody was there. The place was quiet, the water was still, and the tile bottom was as clean as a bathtub. So he says that it was all quiet and I saw that the water was also very still because nobody was there in the water. And he could very clearly see the bottom of the swimming pool. It was as clean as a bathtub. I was timid about going in alone. So I was feeling timid. I was feeling shy to go in alone and I was frightened also. So I sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. So he did not want to go alone because he always wanted to ape others. And so what he did, he just sat there beside the pool and waited for others. I had not been there long when came a big bruiser of a boy, probably 18 years old. So he says that he had been sitting there for quite some time when suddenly a big bruiser of a boy, what is bruiser of a boy? A very tough, rough and tough boy came. And he says that that boy was about 18 years old. He had thick hair on his chest. He was a beautiful physical specimen with legs and arms that showed rippling muscles. So he says that he was a grown-up boy who had thick hair on his chest, and he had a very, you know, beautiful physique, strong arms and legs and all that. And he yelled, "Hi, skinny, how do you like to be ducked?" So immediately what did the boy do? The fat bruiser of a boy, what did he do? He just looked at the narrator who was sitting there and shouted at him. What did he shout? "Hi, skinny, how would you like to be ducked?" So he's calling him skinny because he was very thin. And he's asking him, "Would you like to be ducked?" means thrown into the water. With that, he picked me up and tossed me into the deep end. So this fat boy, bruiser of a boy, 18 years old boy, what he did? He took the narrator and threw him at the deep side of the water. I landed in a sitting position, swallowed water and went at once to the bottom. So as soon as he threw him into the water, what happened? He landed in a sitting position and then he started going quickly down to the bottom of the swimming pool. And meanwhile, he was also swallowing water. I was frightened but not yet frightened out of my wits. So he's saying that I was frightened because suddenly someone took me and threw me into the water, but not frightened out of my wits means I still had my mind and I was able to think. So on the way down, I planned. So as he was moving down towards the water, he had some plan in his mind. When my feet hit the bottom, I would make a big jump, come to the surface, lie flat on it and paddle to the edge of the pool. So what was the plan? When I go down with my feet, I will hit the bottom so that I will make a big jump and come to the surface. And when I come to the surface, what I will do? I lie flat on it and paddle. That means use his hands and legs and come to the edge of the pool. So this was his plan. It seemed a long way down, but those 9 feet were more like 90. So, but as he was moving down, he says that it looked as if this 9 feet was like 90 feet. And before I touched the bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. So he's saying that before I could touch the bottom and jump up, I felt that my lungs were full and ready to burst. But when my feet hit the bottom, I summoned all my strength. So he's saying that when his feet hit the bottom, he gathered all the courage and made what I thought was a big spring upwards. And he thought that he was making a big jump upwards as he had planned. I imagined I would bob to the surface like a cork. So what he thought that by hitting at the bottom, he would come up to the surface just like a cork comes up quickly. Instead, I came up very slowly, but then his movement towards the surface of the pool was very slow. I opened my eyes and saw nothing but water. So as he was inside the water, he could see only water everywhere. Water that had a dirty yellow tinge to it. I grew panicky and he felt that the water was slightly yellow in color. And I grew panicky means I started getting frightened. I hope you liked today's video. We'll do the next part of this lesson in my next video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.